Hello, ladies and gents, and welcome to another episode of Cycling Insider. In this episode of Cycling Insider, let's talk about speed. Everybody likes speed, so this time I've got something special, and it comes from the Canyon bikes. So if you are one of the persons who likes ultimate speed on their bike, I think you're just gonna love this new offering from Canyon. It's their 2019 Canyon iRod CF SL Disc 8.0 Di2. Such a long name as usual, coming from Canyon. But the thing to keep in mind is that this bike, the range from Canyon iRod, is all about ultimate speed. So everything is designed and optimized so you can achieve the highest possible straight line speed. I've heard a lot of good things about the Canyon iRod bikes. Different tests have also confirmed their quality and speed. So I think you should really be excited about this 2019 Canyon iRod. Just to immediately put out a few important things about the Canyon iRod. So I'm now on the Canyon's UK website. As always, in the top right corner, you can change your country and the currency. But the way it stands now, Canyon iRod CF SL Disc 8.0 Di2 has the price of 4,249 British pounds. And on top of that, you always need to add about 50 British pounds for the delivery and packaging. So let's call it 4,300 British pounds. It is a high price, it is a bit of eye-watering price, and there's no denying. But I just believe that currently, when I look at the bike offerings from other manufacturers, considering what this bike offers, it is a fair price. And another good thing is that kind of Canyon obviously listens to their customers. So now I see you can choose between three colors from this bike. One is the Stealth one. One is this blue fade that I'm currently looking at, which is absolutely gorgeous, blue, black, and white. And then there is this Aero Silver, which I also consider could be absolutely beautiful. If I could see it, if you would basically see it, this would be also one of the fantastic colors. But for now, if I would be buying it right now, I would probably go with the blue fade. It's such a classic Canyon color, and also the color that you can see on the Movistar team in the Grand Tours, which are also riding Canyon bikes. One more important thing about Canyon bikes, I've been discussing this in the last few videos and a few people asked, is about the Canyon warranty. So Canyon warranty is 6 years. It has kind of let's say two parts. Immediately you get a 2 year warranty, but then when you register your bike, as far as I know, they will extend it for another 4 years. So in total you have 6 years of warranty on your basically frame, fork, and some other components. And I think it's totally fine. I've rarely heard people having problems with Canyon frames, and I believe that the customer service will sort it out pretty quickly and you will just get a new updated frame. So let's dive in and let's see what's so interesting about this new 2019 Canyon iRod in the 8.0 version, Di2 version. So if I scroll down to the components, let's start with the frame. Frame is the Canyon's iRod carbon fiber frame, and also Canyon Aeroblade SL carbon fiber fork. So the SL range in Canyon is just one step below their top tier range, which is the SLX. But let's be honest, for majority of people who are gonna use this bike, like weekend warriors or even competing in certain levels of cycling, it's more than enough to stick with the SL range, because SLX range of course gives you the premium carbon fiber frame and forks, but also comes with a steep price increase. So I would personally stick with the SL range. Moving on to the headset is the Canyon's Acros kind of collaboration. Moving on to the mechs, we have the rear mech, which is the Shimano Ultegra Di2 11 Speed. We also have the front mech, which is the Shimano Ultegra Di2 11 Speed. And the front shifters, of course, electronic Shimano Ultegra groupset. So full Shimano Ultegra groupset, no cutting corners here. If I look at the brakes are also from Shimano Ultegra family. These are hydraulic disc brakes. And I'm just going to quickly now double check. Do they say about the size of the rotors? I hope, yes, it's 160mm Shimano rotors with the iStack technology, so for the better cooling. And I'm so glad that Canyon has included 160mm rotors on this speed machine, because really you need big rotors, you need big stopping power, because the speeds you can reach on this machine can easily go off over 50 km/h easily. When I look at the cassette of this bike, we have a Shimano Ultegra 11 speed cassette. It's 1128, of course, 28 sprockets. They didn't go 32 or 34. There's no need, because this bike is solely focused on straight line speed. So you really want this cassette to be the small cassette to give you the highest possible speed. Moving on to the wheel set. This is a nice touch from Canyon, and I'm so glad I did it. So here we have a DT Swiss Arc 1400 D-Cut DB wheel set. Again, a mouthful of the name. But one thing to keep in mind, it's a carbon fiber wheel set. Absolutely brilliant stuff coming from DT Swiss. You can't go wrong with DT Swiss wheels and hubs. And this one comes with the rim depth of 62.5mm. And also, as I'm quickly checking here, it's the tubeless ready clincher rims with the rim width of 27mm front and 28mm rear. So, chapeau to Canyon for including a quality pair of wheels. Because, let's be honest, the bike is 4,300 pounds, so you would definitely expect the wheel set to be top-notch, and it is. Tires on this bike come from Continental Grand Prix Attack 3. In my opinion, Continental is still the benchmark of the quality bicycle tires, so again, a big plus for this bike. When I look at the cranks, we have a Shimano Ultegra 11 speed cranks with the chainrings of 52-36, so you will definitely be able to achieve your maximum speed. For those who can really produce a lot of power, maybe they would change a bit of a bigger chainring from 52 to something bigger, 54, maybe even 56. But I believe that 52 is more than enough, because it's paired with the cassette 1128. Chain is Shimano CNHG 700, that's the Shimano's Ultegra level of chains. Moving on to the cockpit, I see that the Canyon has included their aero cockpit, which they now call H36, and I believe this is the one which is a carbon fiber cockpit. I don't think they would kind of save any special money here. Saddle comes from Physique, it's Physique Arione R5. But as always, saddles are a personal preference, so you might decide to change it, and it's not so expensive, so it's easy to just swap the saddle. Seat post is the famous Canyon's Aero VCLS seat post, 27mm width, if I'm not wrong, I think it should be, and it's a carbon fiber seat post, so it's a nice touch, because this bike is definitely going to be stiff, because if you want to reach the highest possible speed, you need the stiffness of the carbon fiber. So a bit of seat post which has a bit of flex is always a nice touch. And if I'm just going to quickly check the weight of the bike, it's 7.6 kilograms inside size medium, which I absolutely consider as an excellent mass for this bike. Just keep in mind that the UCI weight limit for the professional bikes in the Grand Tour is 6.8 kilograms. So this aero machine is 7.6 kilograms size medium, absolutely perfect mass, you can't complain, it's too heavy. So just to conclude about the 2019 Canyon Iroad CFSL Disc 8.0 in the DI2 electronic version. So it's a carbon fiber frame and fork, Iroad range ultimately optimized for straight line speed. We have also a carbon fiber seat post, full Shimano electronic group set, 11 speed group set, including Shimano Ultegra cassette and chain. And a nice touch is the DT Swiss 1400 DB cut wheels, which are carbon fiber wheels wrapped in Continental tires. So all in all, 4,300 British pounds with delivery for this bike, which I consider is a fair price considering what it offers. And checking out some other competition for now, nobody is even close with the level of equipment and the price on offer. So once again, Canyon has really done a good job for 2019, and I'm really proud that they listen to their customers and they really know how to hit that sweet, sweet spot of the equipment and price. So I think this is gonna be it for today. I hope you like what I'm doing. If you do, please do subscribe. I will leave a bit more description in the kind of video YouTube description below, so you can get a few more links to the bike and a few more links to some books if you want to read more. And I will see you soon in the next episode. Pura Vida!